Hi folks, this is John Eisman from LastChanceAutoRestore.com. Today we're standing in front of one of our completed Restomod projects. This is a 68 Ford Mustang. And we're quite proud of it. We've done an extensive amount of work and a lot of upgrades to this car. It started its life as a basic Mustang, a 302 two-barrel carb, four-wheel drum brakes with no power. And it did not come with the engine. So it gave us an opportunity to do some different things to this vehicle. So we basically freshened it up and gave it a newer attitude, if you will. So you can notice from the front, looking at it, we've got the upgraded GT looking grille. So it's all new trim. And then we've added these authentic glass fog lights built in. This is a one-off hood. If you come down this side, you can see the snorkel style hood. This is a one-off that we had made for the car. It has the high rise on it because the engine, which I'll share with you after we walk around the car, is totally different. It's a 5-liter fuel injected motor out of a 1988 Mustang GT, but I'll share with that later. So we needed a little more height because we tweaked the engine, so we went with this custom hood. As you come down the side, you'll notice the stance of the car. It's a little bit lower. We've got bigger wheels on it. So these are a nice aftermarket Eagle 1 five-spoke wheel. We've upgraded the brakes, so now we have a complete power disc brake conversion kit. So now we have power brakes front and rear. There are heavy-duty drums on the back, and then there are the four piston calipers on the front with the rotors. You'll notice on the side of the car, this lower portion. Most people, when they build a Mustang, they like to call it either a GT350, a GT500, or a we wanted to refrain from that, so this decal is removable if someone who buys the car didn't want the white decal, and we called it a GT5.0, which is hinting about the 5.0 fuel injected motor. We've got the correct and the brand new Scott Drake Mustang insignias on the fender, new mirrors and so on, and all new trim around the windshield. As you come down the side, we've two-toned the little vent scoop on the side. Normally the outer casing, that's a two-piece, and normally this outer casing is painted the same color as the car with the little stainless inset, where we thought it looks a little bit more of a definition having the black outline. We have all new handles and locks, and then when you open the door, you'll see it's a totally custom interior. There's some videos that we have on our website that show these are a TMI seat. Believe it or not, so we've got buckets and console on the front, and then if I get out of the way, I'll just fold this forward, and you can see that we've got buckets and console in the rear also. So believe it or not, you use the original Ford seat frames and then you remove everything basically and start over. So you're just using the frames and the springs, and then you're adding the foam and then these custom seats. And they're very, very nice. There's a lot more support in them, and I don't know if you can pick it up in the camera. This is suede on the inserts here and also in the back, and then the leather with the vents. As you look at the dashboard, one of my pet peeves, in my opinion, is a typical Mustang 67, 68 is quite a plain dash. Everything is kind of like a matte black with a little bit of chrome accents. With this one, we've tweaked it quite a bit. We've purchased, it's a complete aluminum, polished aluminum face kit. And the grain, I don't know if the camera will be able to pick it up, but the grain all goes the same way. So this is not just a stick-on MacTac kind of thing. This is a real aluminum kit that really changes and freshens up the dash. As you get a little bit closer in terms of the clusters, you'll notice the Speedo face, and then your fuel gauge and so on. They're all white face gauges, which we've changed. So we've basically opened everything up, freshened everything, changed the resistors, gave it a newer, fresher look. And then the bulbs on the dash at nighttime are an LED. So they have more of a glow, more of an updated look at night. Something that's kind of a neat touch is in between the large dials, you'll see a clock. So that's a reproduction Scott Drake analog clock, and I think it's a really nice touch. So we added that. To the right of that, the stereo, it looks like it's a normal plain Ford Mustang radio, typically period correct looking for 68. However, it's made by Retro Sound and it's fully electronic. As soon as you turn it on, it becomes digital, and then it has the MP3 and all that sort of neat stuff for plugins. I don't know if you can see it, but on the passenger side, it's a little dark there. We've added custom speaker pockets in the kick panel. So typically that would just be a plain piece of plastic in there. And we upgraded with 5 1/4 inch speakers in the tow panels, both driver and passenger side, for the stereo. I think you can pick it up with the camera. And then the rears, we've got a new deck, and it has 6x9 speakers in the back on either side, which kind of gives it some really nice sound. You'll notice you've got the wood steering wheel, excuse me, and you have the correct Mustang horn button. The console, we've upgraded. So this car would typically, it was an automatic transmission. We've upgraded the drive line. And that transmission is actually now a T5, so it's a 5-speed manual, and you'll notice it's a Hurst shifter package, and then we have the tachometer, which is tastefully done inside the console, so it's not overbearing. Doesn't get in the way of your visibility up near the windshield or the pole up in the post that some people would do. So we think it's really nice. The red stitching matches the exterior paint. So you've got everything kind of tying in, and that's something that we really like to do here at Last Chance Auto Restore, is when we come up with a theme for a car. So this paint finish, excuse me, you're fighting a cold. This paint finish is called Vermilion Red, and this is a base coat, clear coat. It was all done here at our restoration facility, and what we wanted to do is tie in the exterior with the interior. So by having the red stitching accents matching the red, and then just subtle little bit of chrome with the aluminum, and then white striping with the white face gauges, we think it's all a nice tie-in and quite a nice appearance. As you come down the back of the vehicle, you'll see once again, we got the Eagle One alloys, the tires in the back are a little bit wider than the ones in the front. We have the correct marker lights, excuse me, for 68. And then in the back of the vehicle, you'll see that we have the new trim along here. In a previous video that we have, we have got the LED tail lights, so they look like bone stock. It's all new chrome, and they're LED and they're programmable, so you can have them sequential or normal, so they're a little bit, quite a bit brighter. We have new reverse lights, and then we have the custom exhaust. And then if we open up the trunk, other than being a little bit dusty in here, you'll see it's quite clean inside. We've changed the location of the battery. We went with an upgraded Optima battery. Just because we're limited in terms of the room or space in the front engine bay, we decided to put the battery in the back, and you'll see the nice carpet. Pardon me. And then we have the Mustang insignia. And then this unit right here is the aftermarket LED controller, so you can control for sequential tail lights. There's about 7 or 8 different settings. So we have that. And then as we come around this side, you'll see the stance is quite nice. The rear end is now a 3.55 axle ratio. It's a heavy duty, and it's also posi traction. So the stance is quite nice. The rear has been lowered an inch, and the front has been lowered an inch correctly with lowering springs. So we didn't cut or chop anything. This is extremely safe in terms of how we've done it, in terms of the layout. And then if we open from the passenger side, you'll see that we've got the stainless kick panel with the Ford logo. And then once again, you see we've got the 3-point safety belts for the front, and they're retractable, where typically in 68, which is the first year for the 3-point seat belts, they normally, excuse me, were separate. So you'd have the lap belt and then the over shoulder belt hung off the top of the roof, where we've upgraded to a 3-point safety belt, and it's retractable, just a little bit cleaner, more updated look. So that's in terms of the upholstery inside and all new carpeting and so on. And if we move along to the front of the car, we'll just lift up the hood and we'll show you there's quite a difference in terms of the original appearance. excuse me. So once again, what we've done is we've removed the normal 302 plane engine. So now we have what we would call a donor engine. So this came out of an 88 GT, and then we've tweaked it. So basically, we started with a nice engine, which is a fuel-injected motor. We rebuilt it, replaced all the gaskets and seals and so on, and then we did some enhancing. So we upgraded. It's dirty right now from a couple of road tests, so we'll have to get this cleaned up, but you'll see we've got the Ford Racing high-polished chrome valve covers by Ford Racing. You'll see the headers that we have are ceramic coated, and they're the long style header. You can see the detail of the engine in terms of the water pump, the front case, front cover. You'll notice that everything was painted individually, and then the gaskets were separate, reassembled properly. And then we have an upgraded Edelbrock Performer RPM2 intake, which gives it a little more attitude and a little bit happier revving engine. And then the lower intake is once again an upgraded Edelbrock, which works together quite nicely. And then we changed the throttle body to a larger 70 mil BBM throttle body, and then we have cold air induction. So in overall presentation, it's quite nice other than being dirty. You'll notice that we have the original stamp serial numbers on the inside. These are a nice touch. We've got the upgraded, they're a billet style hinge with shocks built in. You can see the new master cylinder and power booster. That's all part of the upgraded kit. And then once we have that, we've got the little filler here, which is for the clutch reservoir. So we originally built this vehicle, we had it at the cable clutch, which was quite a bit heavier, and I wasn't quite happy with it. So what we did, we removed the clutch cable system and we upgraded it to a hydraulic. So it's a fully hydraulic clutch, much easier in terms of feel, and much more enjoyable going through all the five gears. In terms of the cooling, we've upgraded the radiator. So now we have a 3-core, top of the line, fully aluminum rad. And then you'll notice on the side here, we've got the coolant overflow, which is also aluminum, and the caps are upgraded to match. And then from the side here, you'll see you've got the electric fan, and then we have a rheostat here. So it's automatically gonna control the fan on and off whenever you need to. So the nice thing about this, you take a 68 Mustang that was kind of plain, not a lot of options, and you can personalize it and make it much more enjoyable. So now we've got a 5-liter fuel injected motor, a much happier engine. Instead of being a 4-speed manual, you now have a 5-speed transmission, a 3.55 axle ratio. So the handling, the drivability is much more comfortable. However, you've got the old classic looking style of the 68. So I just wanted to share with you, we're quite happy with this build, the way it turned out. I'm quite partial to red, but I really like this vermilion red. It's quite a smart color. And all of this work that was done on this Mustang was done here in our facility. So we didn't send anything out. Some facilities will send engines out and have interiors done somewhere else and body and paint and all that sort of thing. Everything that you see here, this complete build, was done all in-house with our staff here at Last Chance Auto Store. So I just wanted to share with you, we're quite happy with this car. I'll just put the hood back down. I've got the extra hood prop here. So that's quite a smart looking car in our opinion. So once again, it's a 1968 Restomod Mustang. We encourage you to visit our website. It's lastchanceautorestore.com. And I'm John, and thank you for watching.